see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Welcome to the It's in Queens podcast. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons, and this is the only podcast that focuses on my borough of Queens. This podcast is brought to you each week by the Queens Economic Development Corporation and the Queens Tourism Council, which spotlights Queens as a destination to visit, to do business, to grow a business, or to just live. As usual, I was sitting in a park this past weekend, what's new about that, and thoroughly enjoyed the good weather while I read a book. This one, of course, was about the history of Yiddish theater in New York City. I'm very diverse in my reading. I then took a long walk through the neighborhood, and as usual, I noticed the changes in some local businesses, some new openings, some closed, and I wondered if that was temporary or permanent. This pandemic really has wreaked so much havoc on businesses. But at the same time, over the last 2.5 years, I found myself going out of my way to support local businesses in my neighborhood. They have needed all the support they could get at this time. That's the bread and butter of what QEDC does, in fact, supporting businesses in our borough. And that's why I want to make sure that this podcast regularly features ways in which they do that, so you, the It's in Queens podcast's devoted listeners, can find out and explore opportunities where QEDC can help you or a friend or a family member. Throughout the month of June, I've been featuring several of the winners of the QEDC's 16th annual Queens Startup Business Plan Competition, which involves a challenge and instruction course that takes place over a few months. And the competition is for the founders of Queens-based startups and small business entrepreneurs who are in the early stages of developing their businesses. Over the course of this year's competition, around 200 participants got technical support and training on business topics like operations, marketing, and financial statements. And then many of those 200 submitted their business plans to a panel of judges. And a few weeks ago, QEDC announced the 4 winners of the competition, which, by the way, is sponsored by Resorts World New York City. And each winner gets $10,000 to jumpstart their business. How about that? So, I reached out to all the winners, and this week, I bring you my conversation with Eli Goldman, an Astoria resident who won in the competition's community category. He makes and sells delicious smoked meats from different brick-and-mortar stores on a pop-up basis and donates half of the proceeds to local charities like Safe Horizon, Make-A-Wish Foundation, and the Astoria Food Pantry. Here's that interview. Eli Goldman, welcome to the It's in Queens podcast.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. Happy to be here and excited to talk with you.
First off, let me find out more about you. Who is Eli Goldman?
My name is Eli. I'm a resident of Astoria, Queens, and I've been here in the city since 2015 now. So it's been a while, but yeah.
What brought you to Queens?
I just finished up a 4-year stint in AmeriCorps, which is essentially the Domestic Peace Corps. I graduated college in 2011, so I was just living around the country. I started off in Trenton, New Jersey, then Philadelphia, then Newark, New Jersey, and then I went out to California to do AmeriCorps as well. And when I finished and came back, I was at my parents in Jersey in 2014. I was definitely not the type of youth or young person in their 20s that wanted to stay at home. So I was like, I immediately was like, I have to get out of here. So I started basically crashing on people's couches. And just like, you know, staying in New York during the week, working at a restaurant and then going on job interviews. And then eventually it paid off and I got a job in about October 2015 fundraising for Safe Horizon.
Ah, Safe Horizon. We've done some work with them. So I would love you to tell the story about the origin of Tikkun BBQ. What led you to create it?
So it's called Tikkun BBQ. Which derives its name from this Jewish philosophy or concept called Tikkun Olam, which means help prepare the world. I definitely don't think I'm important enough or like wise enough or powerful enough or anything like that to like help, or like even that I would know like where to begin about like helping repair the world. This has just basically been a project though, about like giving back and like trying to work with others in a collaborative manner. So to me, like Tikkun Olam means that you should do everything in your power to like help make the world like a less terrible place for not only yourself, but like more importantly, your community. And I think it began, well, not I think, it began during the pandemic where I, like so many other people around the world, were just like locked at home, basically. It was a really scary time. And I think I needed something to ground myself. So I started baking bread and luring it in a basket to like anyone who wanted after I saw this story about Italians doing the same thing, I think in Rome or somewhere. But I was like, oh, wait, I live on a third floor apartment, I can do the same. And then I realized that I also had a smoker, which could make a lot more food than I could bake bread in this tiny oven. So then I switched it up to doing bread and barbecue. And then eventually it became so much barbecue where I was just like, I can't bake bread anymore. So yeah, that's where it started basically. And then it went from my balcony to the gated area in front of my building, to the sidewalk, to the middle of the 31st Avenue Open Streets program. And now we are a legitimate entity, have incorporated like all that stuff, won the QEDC grant, and we do pop-ups with different bars, restaurants, and breweries in the area.
I want to step back for a moment. Were you always a good cook?
I mean, I've always liked cooking, but like, did I ever take it as seriously as I do now? No, absolutely not. Like, I've definitely gotten a lot more serious with it over the past 2 years, but I've always like loved having parties and socializing and like bringing people together like over food. So like whenever I had an apartment party or a summer party, like, yeah, I'd be grilling hot dogs and stuff. Like, was it as of the higher quality that it is now? Like when I do these pop-ups? No, but like food has always been a part of my life, especially growing up in a Jewish household where my mom cooked and like we did all the holidays and all that jazz for sure.
And since you started this amid the pandemic, how has this turned into a business and grown, and how did, was it word of mouth? How did people find out about you?
Well, part of it was that at the very beginning people were like, why the hell is this dude lowering a basket from his balcony to people in the street? So I think it was just a lot of like, what's going on here? And then when we were in the middle of the 31st Avenue, when they were closing it on the weekends for the 31st Avenue Open Streets program, people were like, why is there a dude with a smoker in the middle of the street? So I definitely intentionally made a bit of a spectacle of myself to like get some awareness. And then Astoria also has like a very active subreddit thread, which is basically like online messaging boards. Like Reddit has like, I don't even know how many, probably millions of threads about like random topics. It could be centered around like an identity or like a neighborhood or a sports team or whatever. New York City has one, and then so do many neighborhoods. Our neighborhood subreddit happens to be one of the biggest, if not most active, of all the neighborhoods in NYC. And like people started posting me about what I was doing there. And then it just like grew from that. We don't have like a marketing team or anything. It's literally just me. So like the way we were getting the word out and still do is like, we'll post on Reddit. We will share content on Instagram and like tag bigger accounts who then share it. So it's sort of like using their ecosystem, like they get the word out, and then using like Facebook groups too. We finally got a website as well, but for a long time, it was literally just like word of mouth and social media, and that was it.
Talk about the philosophy behind your business.
The philosophy behind our business is that it's not like a traditional business. It's kind of like an amalgamation between a social enterprise, a nonprofit, like a government agency, a mutual aid group. And like, we draw a lot of inspiration from like across the board. Our mission specifically is using barbecue as a vehicle to build, enrich, and support our community, which we take to mean Astoria and Queens. And we really like want to branch out more into Queens since we've been so centered in Astoria. And the overriding philosophy is that like, it's about more than barbecue. Like, yes, like barbecue, our number one goal is to make exceptional barbecue. And then our second goal is to, build a table and invite everyone to have a seat at it. And then the third is to help others build their own table. And that right there, I think like really just like gets into the fact that like, we're doing so much more than barbecue. So like, we're doing something on the 25th, where we're giving out like Narcan kits and like doing Narcan trainings. We collect food, canned food for food pantries at our events. We've done voter registration, political action around certain causes that we feel like impacts our community, coat drives, etc. And it's not just like once or twice or like around the holiday times. Like we do this consistently like throughout the year, whether it's like a typical time to do such activities or not. Because like to us, it's not about like, you know, the stereotypical like philanthropy, like we're well off and like giving out something. We really want this to be about like true support for the neighborhood and collaboration like year round. And anything we can to basically accomplish that, like I'm trying to do that with our barbecue.
And for our listeners who don't know about Narcan training, I've been through that as well with one of the nonprofits I work with, the Alliance for Positive Change. And it's very important, especially when you're seeing all the stories around the country yeah. and the state about the steep rates of overdoses, especially during the pandemic. Why was it important for you to give back and talk about some of the organizations you've supported?
It's important to give back. I mean, that's like partially how I was raised. Like my mom was a fundraiser herself for nonprofits, and like whether we wanted to or not, she would take us out to like volunteering opportunities. I think at the time, like as a kid, I was probably groaning and complaining, but I think in retrospect, it really taught me that, you know, you can't wait on other people to take an active role or stance on things. And if you do, you know, you're going to be waiting a long time and it may never happen. So it's kind of like, I feel like the time is now and it always is now. And like, you know, I wish social progress would happen quicker than it does. Sometimes it takes, not sometimes, I feel like almost entirely it always takes too long. But the point is that like, you have to start somewhere. And to me, a business, especially a food business, is like restaurants always talk about being a part of the community. And I think like, to be clear, some really do demonstrate that, but a lot just like, you know, they're like, we sell food and we're in a neighborhood there and we're a part of the community. I'm like, sure, you're a part of it, but you're really not doing like as much as you could be. You know, and I think it's really, for me, it's really about going above and beyond to like really, really demonstrate like what we think it means to be a community and mission based restaurant or food entity. Cause that's also like another way we really describe ourselves is like, we're more than barbecue. We're a community mission driven pop up.
This award, $10,000 from the Queens Economic Development Corporation, what will it mean for your business?
It means that we can expand. I mean, it's really hard to donate as much money as we have. I think we've helped generate like $90,000 in donations, which is great because like we all work full-time jobs outside of this. So like we're not doing this like personally enrich ourselves. But then it's kind of hard then to expand because like all the money that we could have used for that expansion is, you know, helping fuel things like Astoria Food Pantry, the NAACP, the ACLU, City Harvest, City Year, so many great and worthy causes. So this grant, though, really helps us to accelerate our growth without having to draw back on the donations as much.
And what else is on the horizon for you? You said you also, this is not the full-time job.
Not yet. I don't know if it ever will be, to be clear. I mean, barbecue is like very, very intense. I mean, it's long, long hours. And it's really hot and it's great. I love it. But like, I don't know if I love it quite that much, but like, we'll see. But yeah, I mean, on the horizon is the fact that we're getting this like large smoker on the 18th and then we have a pickup truck coming to tow it. So just like this expansion is exciting and like it means that like instead of selling out in 2 hours, like we'll be able to like serve like more people and therefore raise more money and therefore help more people and have a bigger impact on our community. And like to us, like it's really not about like how big our paycheck is, it's more about like how big of an impact we can have on other people, because that's what I was started for. So yeah,
that sounds fantastic. Where can our listeners go if they want to learn more about you and your business? And also if they would like to try some of your product?
They can go to tikkunbbq.com or we're very active on Instagram. So our handle is Tikkun, TikkunBBQ.
Eli Goldman, thank you so much for appearing here today on the It's in Queens podcast.
Awesome. Thank you.
I was checking out the Tikkun BBQ's events page, and I see there's a number of pop-up events on the horizon. In Astoria on July 9th, Long Island City on July 23rd, Astoria again on August 20th, and that list goes on this fall. And every Thursday, they post a menu online. My mouth is watering while I say this. There have been things like brisket and mighty oak beef ribs and honey glazed chicken, mac and cheese, and grilled watermelon and feta, perfect for the summer. So much more is on that website. So go to tikkunbbq.com. TikkunBBQ.com. Check out that menu. I do not think you will be sorry at all. If the Queen's Startup Business Plan competition is of interest to you, you may have an idea in mind and you want to learn how to develop and refine that, then go to the QEDC's website. It's very important. You should go to the QEDC's website, queensny.org, queensny.org. Now, if you're thinking about this summer, things you want to do, you're not sure yet, where do I go? What's going on? I have got the answer for you. Heading into this holiday weekend, we have you covered. That is where Rob McKay comes in. He's with the Queen's Economic Development Corporation and the Queen's Tourism Council. And each week, he highlights several of the more exciting events that are happening in Queens.
Hi, Jeff. How are you? Since the weather's nice, we're going to keep you outside for this week. In fact, it's really the most that's going on is outside. Mostly movies and some music. So let's start with the outdoor movies. These are all free in local parks and in most cases family fun or family friendly. Men in Black shows on July 1st in the Queens Botanical Garden, while the Spider-Man No Way Home, that's the one where Peter Parker's identity is revealed, shows the same day over at the Unisphere in Flushing Meadows Corona Park. July 6th is Sing 2, which is, I guess you would describe it as a family-friendly musical music film. And July 7th is Encanto, which is at Corona Plaza. That's the movie about a teenage Colombian girl who's the only member in her family who doesn't have magical powers. I should mention that Sing 2 will be at the Unisphere. There's also tons of outdoor music in Jackson Heights. In fact, right around the block from where you live, the Jackson Heights Orchestra will play classical music at Traverse Park as part of the ongoing Music in the Park series on July 3rd. The Evan Sherman Big Band will perform on July 4th, which is Independence Day, and it's arguably Louis Armstrong's birthday, so they have a celebration there every year. And it'll involve live music and maybe some cake, and if you're lucky, some rice and beans. Taikaso, which is the big Japanese drums called taiko drums. So a group will be playing that. They create these thunderous rhythms, and then they use bamboo flutes to create a wind sound as well. They'll be performing in Alipon Park on July 5th. And Rubik's Cube. Rubik's Cube is an 80s tribute band. They'll be playing in Juniper Valley Park in Middle Village on July 7th. They can kind of do everything from the 80s. Madonna, Michael Jackson, Cher, Prince, Paul Abdul, Guns N' Roses, maybe a little We Are Devo, some Bon Jovi, some Boy George. So they're absolutely hilarious, those guys, in a great show. And there's also even an outdoor puppet variety show at the Unisphere on July 6th. There are other things outdoor, too, that I'm not going to talk about. Please catch it all at itsinqueens.com, okay? Jeff, hope to see you at each and every single one of these events. Okay, bye.
That is just a sample of all that's happening in our borough. And remember, the place to go once again to discover and explore everything that's on the horizon, well, it's very, very easy to remember. What's the name of this podcast? It's the It's in Queens podcast. So you just got to go to the It's in Queens website, itsinqueens.com. And again, if you are interested in more business news, how to help your business or a friend's business, make a point to visit QEDC's website at queensny.org. And when you are there, sign up for their newsletter. You'll get notified about things right in your inbox. Now, the July 4th weekend is upon us right now. You're going to hopefully take a nice staycation. You're going to take it easy. You'll get some sun, maybe some sand, some me time. When you do a lot of this, snap a photo and share it with us. Make sure to tag us on Instagram and Twitter. Use the hashtag #ItsInQueens. Who knows? Your photo could become our photo of the week. So I wish you all a very happy July 4th weekend. I will see you next week. I'm your host, Jeff Simmons, and that's it for this week's It's in Queens podcast.
I see trees of green, red roses. roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces.